Good morning and welcome to the fourth part of our topic, transformation of sentences. In our previous topic, in third part of this transformation of sentences, we read rules and examples of transforming simple sentence into complex sentences. Today in this class, we will study rules and examples of transforming complex sentences into simple sentences. As you know that converting simple sentence into complex sentence can be done easily, and this can be done by simply expanding a word or a phrase into a clause. Similarly, we can do the same thing when we want to change the complex sentences into simple sentences. And this can be done by eliminating a clause into a word or phrase. So here some examples and rules are given that are related to the transformation of complex sentences into simple sentences. So let us begin our topic. Before going to the rules and examples, let us know what is complex sentence. We have already discussed this one in our previous topic, clauses, but from the very beginning of the topic, transformation of complex sentences into simple sentence, we will start from its definition. So what is complex sentence? A sentence which consists of one main clause and one or more than one subordinate clause is known as complex sentences. Listen carefully. A sentence which consists of one main clause and one or more than one subordinate clause is known as complex sentence. Let us see the example. Delhi, which is the capital of India, is about 1,464 kilometers from Kolkata, which was the old capital. So, a sentence which consists of one main clause and one or more than subordinate clauses. Example, Delhi, which is the capital of Delhi of India, is about 1,464 kilometers from Kolkata, which was the old capital. Or we can say that a sentence which has one independent clause and one dependent clause is called a complex sentence. A sentence which has one independent clause and one dependent clause is called a complex sentence. Let us see the example. Although he was ill, he attended the meeting. Although he was ill, he attended the meeting. The rules for transforming complex sentences are, let us begin with the first rule. Number one, rule number one, when the subject of two clauses of a complex sentence, including since or as or when, is same and both have the main verb, then we will add verb plus ing of the first clause plus rest of the verb plus comma plus subject of first clause plus rest part. Listen carefully. When the subject of two clauses of a complex sentence, including since, as or when, any one of these three, then both have the main verb, then verb plus ing of first clause, the rest part, then verb plus comma plus subject of first clause, then rest part will come. Let us clear it with the example. Since I was ill, I could not attend the concert. Since I was ill, I could not attend the concert.
Let us transform it into simple. Being ill, I could not attend the meeting. Being ill, I could not attend the meeting. Let us see second example. When the criminal saw the police, comma, he ran away. When the criminal saw the police, he ran away. So, seeing the police, the criminal ran away. Seeing the police, the criminal ran away. As she performed well, she got the first prize. This is complex sentence. Let us transform it into simple. Performing well, she got the first prize. Means we will start our simple sentence with verb plus ing. Example that we have already read. Being here, we have read that since I was ill, I could not attend the concert. Being ill, I could not attend the meeting. When the criminal saw the police, he ran away. Seeing the police, the criminal ran away. It means we will start our sentence, our simple sentence with verb plus ing. As she performed well, she got the first prize. Performing well, comma, she got the first prize. Next rule. When the subjects of two clauses of a complex sentence are different. Listen carefully. When the subjects of two clauses of a complex sentence are different and have be, verb, am, is, are, was, were, has, have or had, be verb be there, the simple sentence will be, then we will transform the complex sentence into simple sentence by following. Then we will do eliminate the since, as and when and replace am, is, are, was, were using being or in place of has, have, had, we will use having plus second clause. Listen carefully. The second rule is quite difficult. When the subjects of two clauses of a complex sentence are different. Listen carefully. When the subjects of two clauses of a complex sentence are different and have, am, slash, is, are, was, were, has, have or had, the simple sentence will be eliminate the since, as or when. Replace am, is, are, was, were using being or in the place of has, have, had, we will use having plus second clause. Let us see the example, then only you will understand. Since the weather was very bad, comma, we did not start the journey. This is complex sentence. Let us transform it into simple. The weather being very bad, we did not start the journey. Rest of the part will be the same. Just keep this a key point or main thing in your mind that after the comma, the rest part of the sentence will remain as it is and we will use in place of this here was and since. Then we will remove this and was and we will use being. So, since the weather was very bad, we did not start the journey. The weather being very bad, we did not start the journey. When the show was over, we came back. This part will remain as it is and we will use being in place of this was and we will remove this when. that we have already read that, we will remove as, since or when, and we will replace being in place of is, am, are, was, were. So when the show was over, comma, we came back home. The show being over, we came back home. Our next rule, third rule. When the subject of two clauses is same, when the subject of the two clauses is same. In this second rule, we read that if they are different, the subjects. When the subject of the two clauses is same and the subordinate clause has be verb. Be verb means is, am, are, am, is, are, was, were, has, have, had. Then in simple sentence, we will use because of in the place of, since or as, plus possessive form of subject of first clause, plus being in the place of is, am, are, was, were, or having in the place of has, have, that we have already read in our second rule. Plus rest of the part, plus comma and second clause. Listen carefully, the third rule. When the subject of the two clauses is same and the subordinate clause has be verb, that is am, is, are, was, were, has, have, had, then in simple sentence, we will use because of in the place of, since, as. We will use this because of. Okay. Then plus the possessive form of subject of first clause plus being in the place of, in the place of am, is, are, was, were, or we will use having, or having in the place of has, have, had, plus rest part of the sentence, plus comma and second clause. Let us see the example. Since he was ill, comma, he could not attend the meeting. Because being ill, he could not attend the meeting. They were loved by all as they had honesty. They were loved by all because of their having honesty. So in second and third rule, listen carefully, in second rule we read that when the subject of two clauses of a complex sentence are different and have the verb be, is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, the simple sentence will be as, we will eliminate or we will remove since, as, when, and replace, we will replace is, am, are, was, were using being, or in place of has, have, had, we will use having plus second clause. But in third rule, when the subject of the two clauses is same and the subordinate clause has be, were, is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, then in simple sentence, because of in the place of, since or have, since or as, plus possessive form of the subject of first clause, plus being in the place of is, am, are, was, were, or having in the place of has, have, had, plus rest of the part of the sentence, plus comma and second clause. So these two, second and third rules are quite similar. Carefully read the difference, that is different in the subjects. In second rule, when the subjects of two clauses of a complex sentence are different, but in third, when the subject of the two clauses are same. Let us move to our next clause, next rule, fourth rule. When a complex when a complex sentence has relative pronoun, when a complex sentence has relative pronoun, the simple sentence will be from the beginning up to the relative pronoun. Listen carefully. When a complex sentence has relative pronoun, the simple sentence will be from the beginning up to the relative pronoun. Listen, from the beginning to the relative pronoun will be written as it is, plus relative pronoun will be removed, plus the be verb will be removed, plus the main verb plus ing, and the rest part we will use or. Listen carefully this rule, fourth rule. When a complex sentence has relative pronoun, when the sentence, complex sentence is having relative pronoun, the simple sentence will be, listen carefully, from the beginning up to the relative pronoun will be written as it is, plus the relative pronoun will be removed, plus the be verb will be removed, plus the main verb plus ing and the rest part. Let us see the example to clear the rule. A cow that is very strong can plow this land. A cow being very strong can plow this land. So what we have used same being here in place of the verb be, is am, are, was, were. A cow that is strong, that is very strong, can plow this land. A cow being very strong can plow this land. The students who study seriously can get good marks. The students studying regularly can get good marks. The students who study seriously can get good marks. The students studying seriously can get good marks. So the transformation of complex sentence into simple sentence following the fourth rule, you should be very careful related to the pronoun, the part of the pronoun which we will write or which we will remove, and the verb, the be verb, and the main verb plus ing, and the part of the clause that we add or that we will write. Next rule, fifth rule. If the complex sentence has when, listen carefully, if the complex sentence has when, while transforming it into simple, when we will transform this into simple, when will be omitted, plus subject and verb after when will be omitted, plus little time at, if it is season mentioned, if the season mentioned, or if the age is mentioned, we will mention that one. So listen carefully. If the complex sentence has when, while transforming it into simple sentence, when will be omitted, plus subject and verb after when. Listen carefully. When will be omitted, plus subject and verb after when will be omitted, plus little time at. The time is related to, maybe the little time at or time in, related to season if it is mentioned in the sentence, or if the age is mentioned, plus the rest part we will add. Let us see the rule. Let us clarify the rule with this example. What we read in this fifth rule, that if the complex sentence has when, while transforming it into simple, when will be omitted, and the subject and verb after when will be omitted, plus little time, the time related to whatever it is, whether it is related to season if it is mentioned, or if it is related to the age, whatever it is related to in the sentence, plus rest part of the sentence we will add. Let us see the example. When it is summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. In summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. Listen carefully. When it is summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. This is complex sentence. So let us transform it into simple by using the or by following the rule that we read. What we will remove first? When. In summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. Whatever we have read about the rules, we know one thing, or we must keep in mind that the part of the sentence that is after the comma, we will write as it is in each and every sentence. So be carefully, keep this point in mind. When it is summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. In summer, we can eat different kinds of mangoes. When he was 6, he left the country. At the age of 6, he left the country. Here we have mentioned season and here we have mentioned the age. So we will follow the rule according to the topic, according to the condition mentioned here. Here we have mentioned season, that is summer, and here we have mentioned the age of the person, that is 6. So when it is summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. In summer, we can eat different kinds of mango. When he was 6, he left the country. At the age of 6, he left the country. But if the when does not mean time, if does not mean the time or the condition that is related to the age or the season, whatever, rather it means that something is going on, then at the time of plus verbs ing plus rest of part of the sentence we will add. Listen, if the sentence is having when and it is not related to any time or condition or season, then we will use at the time of plus verb plus ing plus rest part of the sentence. Let us see the example. When it was raining, we were sitting in the coffee shop. We were sitting in the coffee shop. Rest part of the sentence will be as it is, and we will remove this when, and we will replace at the time of in place of when. Then we will add verb plus ing, that is rain plus ing, then rest part of the sentence. So let us see the example. When it was raining, we were sitting in the coffee shop. Simple sentence. At the time of raining, what we will have to do is to remove this when and replace this when with at the time of. Then verb first form plus ing, here same raining, then rest part of the sentence. When it was raining, we were sitting in the coffee shop. At the time of raining, we were sitting in the coffee shop. When they were studying, the teacher came. At the time of their studying, the teacher came. At the time of their studying, the teacher came. Next, rule number 6. To transform negative conditional complex sentences having if into a simple form, this rule is followed. Without plus verb plus ing plus second clause. Listen carefully. To transform negative conditional complex sentences having if, that is conditional if, into a simple sentence, then what you will have to do is without plus verb plus ing plus second part or second clause or rest of the sentence. Let us see with the example here. We will remove if, and we will, or we can say that we will replace if with without. If you do not struggle, without struggling, verb plus ing, struggle will become struggling. So if you do not struggle in life, you cannot achieve your goal. Without struggling in life, you cannot achieve your goal. See, it is not difficult. Just you understand the rule and then follow and write the sentences or examples of your own. In sixth rule, what we will have to do is to remove if with without, and we will add verbs plus first form, verbs first form plus ing, then rest of the sentence, or you can say second clause. If you do not struggle in life, you cannot achieve your goal. Without struggling in life, you cannot achieve your goal. If you do not study hard, you will not get good marks in the exam. Let us transform this complex sentence into simple. Without studying hard, you will not get good marks in the exam. In this session, in this class, we will study, or we will have to study only 6 points, because these are quite difficult, and if you will understand the rules, then they will be very easy for you to transform the complex sentence into simple one. So first you go through these 6 points thoroughly, and in our next session, in our next part, we will step ahead to the next rules of our transformation of complex sentences into simple sentences. So thoroughly read the rules and practice yourself. Have a nice day.